Hello, I'm Maria, and I am going to show you how to get a professional email address with a custom domain. Email is the leading communication channel in the workplace. So if you are thinking about starting a business, your own agency, or freelancing, having the right professional email address is essential. In this video, we cover why this is important, provide examples, and walk you through how to get a professional email with a custom domain. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description, and remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. So, let's get started. Your email address is a crucial part of your brand, one that you should protect and improve as much as possible. As a freelancer or business owner, you can't afford the first impression an email address like supermario139@hotmail.com gives off. First off, it's hard to correctly judge who the email is from at a glance. Second, even with a more serious email like john.doe@gmail.com, your email recipients will have no easy way of confirming your identity. An unwillingness to invest in a professional email address indicates that you're not very serious about your business. That's why you want a professional-looking email address. If you are using the company name for the domain name and your email address, you should mix and match it with your first name, last name, or initials. You can also single out your position in the company in the email address if you need the extra authority. In general, anything that includes your actual name or initials is good enough, and there's no need to overcomplicate things. If you've ever worked for a large company, chances are you had an email just like this. If your registered domain name is your full name or last name, there's no need to double up. You can use a filler word like contact or mail, or you can use your position or initials to round out a personal name domain email address. The most significant variable in your business email is the domain name you choose. If you want to be taken seriously as a business by other companies, the least you can do is register the right domain name. If all variations of your full name and initials, as well as your company name, are taken, don't give up hope. The best approach is to combine your company name or name with your location. This will also help your website with SEO for local searches and Google Business listings. If your company isn't based in a location and you're not going to be staying in your current town for a long time, then you have to get a little bit creative. Okay, so you've decided on a custom email domain, but what is the best option to host and handle your emails? You have several different options, from using the options included with your hosting provider to opting for a premium solution like Google Workspace, which is what we use here at Kinsta. Our entire team gets trustworthy, branded email addresses, but they also get to keep the familiar UX of Gmail for their business communications. With best-in-class spam filters, smart search, an intuitive and tidy inbox experience, and extensive add-on integrations, Gmail is one of the best email services out there. And the best part is, we get so much more than just email. All of our team members get 30 gigabytes of storage and access to advanced features in the entire Google suite of cloud apps. You can also use Google Hangouts Chat as an alternative to Slack, or even extend and create custom workflows with Google Apps scripts. Making and registering your first professional email address can seem overwhelming, but it becomes a simple process when you break it down step by step. First, if you don't already have a domain name, you need to register one. You will also need premium web hosting with DNS support. Choose a reliable domain registrar like Google Domains or Namecheap. Search for an available .com, .co, or other popular domain with a combination of your full name or your company name. Stay away from untrusted or cheesy domains like .biz and others. After you've chosen your domain name, proceed to checkout, and you will have become the proud owner of a new domain name. First, head over to the Google Workspace and click the Get Started button. Once you've done that, you will start the signing up process. Fill out the basic required info, including your number of employees, your business name, and your country. It's important to choose the country where your business is registered. Click Next Step to proceed. The next step is to fill out your name and existing email address. Once finished, click the Next Step button. Next, confirm whether or not you have a domain for your business already. If not, you can register one with the Google Domain Registrar before proceeding. If you already have a domain, fill out the domain and click Next Step to continue. Double check that the domain is correct and click Next Step to confirm your selection. Finally, create a username and password to finalize your Google Workspace account. Check the CAPTCHA and press the Agree and Continue button to move on to the next step. Note, if you already have an existing email provider for professional email, make sure that you enter the right username. Confirm that you chose the right payment plan for Google Workspace before you continue. If you've followed along with us this far without an issue, you've successfully created your Google Workspace account. Congratulations. Now that you've created a user, head to Google Admin Console and log in with your new credentials. Once you've logged in, there is a tutorial that will help you set up Google Workspace. You will start by verifying your Google Workspace domain. Click the Verify button to open up your options for domain verification. The default option is adding a text record to the DNS records of your business site. Adding the text record to your DNS won't affect your website or domain in any way. If you're using Kinsta DNS, make sure to check out this tutorial on how to add your Google MX records in My Kinsta. Once you've selected the text option, Google will generate a code that starts with Google-site-verify. Click the copy button to copy the code to your clipboard. Now you need to access the DNS tool of your hosting provider in a new tab or window. Don't close the Google Workspace tab. Existing Kinsta customers should use the Kinsta DNS tool. Click on the Add a New DNS Record button at the top of the page. That should open up a new tab where you can add a record. Select Text from the Type drop-down menu. Copy and paste the verification code and press the Add DNS Record button. Once you're done, return to the tab with the Google Workspace signup page in it. Scroll to the bottom of the page and click the Verify My Domain button to complete the verification. Note, it may take a few minutes for the DNS records to go live, so it will take some time before Google can complete the authentication. If you're not the only employee in your company, this is the best time to add the other users, especially if you already use a different email service to handle emails. Click the Create Accounts button to proceed. Fill out the name and username and click the Add New User button. Repeat for all members of your staff. If your company already has email addresses, ensure that every username matches the existing one exactly. The final step is to activate Gmail for your Google Workspace accounts. Click the Activate button to continue to the next step. On the page, you'll see the following MX records. You'll need to open a new tab and go to your host's DNS tool or reopen the DNS tool tab from earlier. Typically, you would need to copy and paste manually, but not with Kinsta. Since we are big fans of Google Workspace, we have created a one-click solution for helping our customers setting this up quickly. Simply access Kinsta DNS through My Kinsta and click the Add Gmail MX Records button at the top of the page. The MX records, like name servers, are the same, regardless of the user, so you don't have to change anything. Press the Add 5 Records button to proceed. Since it can take some time for the changes to go live, you can take a tea or coffee break before continuing. For other hosts, you need to access your DNS tool, for example, through logging into your cPanel and opening DNS Zone Editor. Select the appropriate domain and then click the Add Record button to open a new window. Fill out the appropriate priority and then copy and paste the destination. Double check that everything is correct and click Add Record to complete. Repeat the process for the four alternative MX destinations. If your host has email enabled by default, you might need to remove existing MX records. Once you're done, you should return to the Google Workspace signup tab and scroll to the bottom of the page and press the Activate button. It will take a moment to verify. If at first it doesn't detect the new records, give it a few minutes and then press the Retry Activation button. Once the changes go live, Google will find the MX records and take you to the final screen. You've now finished setting up your professional email addresses through Google Workspace and can log in through Gmail to access and send emails. All that's left now is to test that your new professional email address is working. Since Google confirmed that you correctly entered the MX records, this is technically not a necessary step, but it's the fastest way to take your new branded email for a spin inside the Gmail inbox. Open another email account. Gmail, Outlook, AOL, it doesn't matter. Compose a new email and enter your new email address in the To field. Write a random subject like first email and send it. Now head over to Gmail and log in with your Google Workspace credentials. If you did everything correctly, you should see the test email you sent from the other account in your inbox. You can also try composing and sending an email the other way around to confirm that you can send emails without issues as well. If you prefer to use your Windows 10 Mail app instead of your browser, it's effortless to set up. If you haven't set up an email account yet, all you have to do is open the app, it will automatically prompt you to add an account. If you already have an active one, log out from it and click the Add New Account link. Next, click the Google button and log in with your Google Workspace credentials. Google will prompt you to confirm that you are allowing Windows to access the data. Just scroll to the bottom and click Allow. Once you've done that, you will be able to read and send emails from within the Windows 10 Mail app. The setup is done and you don't need to do anything else at all. If you don't want to access the Gmail webpage through your browser, you can easily add your new Google Workspace email address to the Mail app. First, open up your Mail application. Then click the Mail option in the top menu to expand the main preferences. Select the Add Account option, choose Google, and then click Continue. From then on, you'll start the easy activation process. If you'd like, you can now even select which apps to sync with the account, not just mail, but also your calendar and notes. You can now send and receive emails from your new address from using the Mail app. Since you've set up your email address through Google Workspace, accessing it on your mobile phone is very simple. If you aren't already using the Gmail app, which is available for both iOS and Android, download it and log in with your freshly created Google Workspace credentials. Easy peasy. If you are already using it with another address, you need to add your new professional email address to it. To do so, open your Gmail app on your phone. On Android devices, press the hamburger icon to expand the menu, scroll to the bottom, and click Settings. From here, all you need to do is click the Add Account link. Next, click the Google button to open the Google account login page. You may have to enter your smartphone's PIN code before being able to continue. Once you see the setup email page, log in with your Google Workspace account. That's it. If you're using an iPhone, the steps are pretty similar. Tap on your thumbnail in the top right corner of the Gmail app. This will bring up a new window where you'll need to choose the Add Another Account option. You should now have the possibility to add your freshly created professional email address. Simply pick Google as your preferred option here. What if you don't want to use the Gmail app, but rather the standard mail app on your devices? Well, here's how to add your professional email address to it. To access your Gmail email address with the default mail app on your Android phone, the first thing you need to do is head to the account settings. Next, tap the Add Account option and select the mail or email application. Email is the default for Samsung phones. Finally, select the Gmail or Google Workspace and log into your new Google Workspace account. Once you've logged in, you will receive emails and notifications from your pro address. On iPhones, you also follow the same process. Open the Passwords and Accounts menu in the general iOS settings. Tap the Add Account option and select Google. Complete your login and wait for the Mail app to verify your login. Finally, select additional settings like Contacts and Address Book and save the new account. You can now access your Google Workspace professional email address from your iOS-powered device. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.